How long does a woman take to get pregnant after using a family planning? Or how long does it take for a woman to regain her fertility after using a certain method of family planning? And then, can a woman ovulate when she is pregnant? All this is what we are going to discuss in this very particular video.
Ask Dr. Uthuman on Sawawo.
Hello, my very good viewers. Welcome to Ask Dr. Uthuman YouTube channel, a channel where I learn medicine at the comfort of your living room. And I told you, if you'd like to get in touch with me to have a private chat, go to my website www.druthuman.com, book an appointment, you will have a private chat with me. However, those who feel free to ask questions on my timelines, you can go to all my social media platforms and ask any question of your choice. I'll be answering you. And if it's your very first time to come to our channel, please don't forget to subscribe and press the notification bell. Today, we are discussing a question from someone called Najingo Viola. She says, "Hi Doc, my name is Viola and I have been on family planning for 2 years and I stopped 2 weeks ago. But I have not seen my periods up to now. Now, many of the questions related to this, these people want to know when they can conceive. These people want to know when they can conceive after using family planning. When can they regain their menses? Because some family planning methods actually make you stop menstruating. They cause amenorrhea, loss of menstruation. So she wants to know when she will resume her regular periods. Again, I know most of you want to know, when can I conceive again? When can I get pregnant again after using a family planning method? Now, colleagues, this depends on the type of family planning you are using. When to regain your fertility, the period it takes you to regain your fertility depends on mainly 3 factors. Number one, the type of family planning you are using, or the type of family planning you used. Number two, how long did you use this family planning? Was there misuse of this method of family planning? So we shall start with the simple ones. Number one of the family planning methods we use is a condom. The moment you cease, you stop using a condom, of course you'll conceive, you regain your fertility. So therefore, with a condom, you regain it immediately. There are several types of condoms, and I want to introduce you to a condom, a female condom. I don't know if any of you has ever seen this. This is a female condom. This is one of the methods of family planning we use. And good enough, this condom also protects you or prevents you from getting sexually transmitted infections, including HIV. So this is a female latex condom. I know most of you understand the male condoms, but we also have a female condom, which we call the FEDEM. Now, with this method, or with a condom use, you will regain your fertility immediately. You stop using it. Now, there are some other methods like the diaphragm and then the spermicides. Those are also methods of family planning, but they are barrier methods. The moment, like for example, the spermicides, these ones kill the sperms. They are inserted down in your V and they kill the sperms. The moment you stop using spermicides, you regain your fertility immediately. Therefore, there is nothing like, when will I regain my fertility? You regain it immediately. Another method is this, the IUD. This IUD, the intrauterine contraceptive device, an IUD. With this method of family planning, you will also regain your fertility immediately because it's a non-hormonal method of family planning. How does it work? I remember in one of my videos, I talked about an IUD and how it works. Now, when you look at this, assume this is your uterus. This is your uterus. These are the fallopian tubes, and assume that there are ovaries here. So the IUD is inserted through your V and it enters the uterus and it will be here. When it is there, it is blocking the passage of sperms. Because sperms, when they are dropped in your V, They are supposed to swim through and enter the fallopian tubes to find the egg during ovulation, and then the fertilization occurs. So these sperms will stop entry of these the sperms. Two, it will also cause the thickening of the uterus, of the underlining of the uterus, the endometrium, and that thickening will not give a good environment for the sperms to swim through. So, plus also providing those mucus and so on that are sticky, that will prevent movement, swimming of the sperms. Now, with an IUD, the moment you remove it, you gain fertility immediately. Therefore, there is no delay. The moment you remove an IUD, the IUD has gotten out, you will conceive, unless there is any other problem as to why you are not conceiving. Now, those barrier methods are the only ones that will bring you to fertility immediately. Now, I should also make this disclaimer. You may be on a bilateral tube ligation or a vasectomy. Bilateral tube ligation is where we cut both of your tubes. We tie them and cut them. Even for many vasectomy, we tie the tube. So if you're using that method, of course, don't expect to come back to fertility. Because someone may have done a BTL and is asking, when can I conceive again? Yet you did a BTL. Just know that a bilateral tubal ligation or a vasectomy is a permanent method of family planning. You will not regain your fertility unless other interventions are made, because there are reversals and so on. Now, we have some other methods called the hormonal methods of family planning. Now, these are the family plannings that usually disturb women because they are hormonal. They contain hormones, synthetic hormones that are similar to the hormones of your body. And they act by contradicting or interrupting with your endogenous hormones or with your homogeneous hormones, the hormones in your body. For example, the emergence pills. Now, when you use an emergence pill, it's a hormonal method, you may not regain fertility immediately. Actually, most emergence pills will take at least a month, two or three. However, if you overuse emergence pills, I discussed about emergence pills. If you overuse emergence pills, like almost every month you're swallowing emergence pills, I am telling you, your fertility may be delayed for many, many years, including, by the way, failure to regain your fertility. Including failure to regain your fertility because you've overused this hormone. It has over-interrupted the endogenous or the homogeneous hormone, and therefore, it may be irreversible unless you do checkups and then take the appropriate medicines. So with emergence pills, we expect you to regain fertility after 1 month of using the pills. Then we also have some other pills, the usual pills, the pill plans, like these ones. I think most of you know these pills, these ones. These family planning pills. These are pills that you take every day. Every day you take one pill. Every day you take one pill, one pill, one pill. And some people, by the way, don't use these pills very well. You find that a woman is taking these pills only when she is going to meet her hubby or when she's going to meet the spouse. No, these pills are supposed to be taken every day. Whether you are going to meet your husband or not, you take them every day. Now, when you are taking these pills and you stop taking them, it may take some time for you to regain fertility. It can be 3 months to 6 months. And if you've used them for a long period of time, someone has used pills, these pill plant pills or Microgynon or whatever, Levonorgestrel, whatever, if you use them for more than a year, 2 years, the fertility may take so long, can even go up to a year, even 2 years without regaining it. But lucky women, 3 months, they're regaining their fertility. Actually, let me tell you, there are stories of women who like just missing, they miss taking one tablet, just one, and they conceive. So women are different in their nature and bodies. So we have another family planning called the injector plan or the injection. This injection is given every 3 months. This is the injection. You know, most of you talk about family planning, talk about the injection, which is given here on the deltoid. It's given on the deltoid muscle. It's given inside the muscle. It's called intramuscular administration. It's given inside the muscle. It contains a hormone or a drug called Depo-Provera. It contains a drug called Depo-Provera. Now, when that injection is taken, actually, it is said that when its time elapses, like it's taken, you've taken it for 3 months and you don't take another one, it can take you between 3 to 4 months to regain your fertility. However, also, with misuse, by misuse or disuse, we mean people who use like injections for a long period of time. I told you, an injection for family planning is a short-term method. Should be used for 3 months, 6 months, and not more than a year. But you find someone who is taking an injection, getting an injection for a period of 5 years. My friend, you may take long to gain your fertility. So let's look at an implant. What about an implant? An implant is a rod. It's like a stick which is inserted below or under the skin of your arm. And with this implant, for example, we have this. This is what we call an implanon next, and it's one, actually the types of implants, we have two of them. We have the implanon and then the jadel. For an implanon, it works for 3 years. In other words, when you insert it, you can spend or you can stay 3 years without getting pregnant. However, a jadel, you can spend up to 5 years without conceiving. And this is an example of an implant, and it's called implanon next. So an implant looks like this. It's a rod around 2 centimeters, and it's inserted. It's very soft. It's a soft stick. It's a soft rod, and it's inserted below or under the skin. We call it the subdermal area. It's inserted there, and like I've said, you can spend around 3 to 5 years without conceiving. Now, when you insert this implant, for example, an implanon, and you remove it, some people conceive immediately. A few of them, around 10% of the people will conceive immediately. However, the largest population will conceive after 6 months, all up to 6 months. And we've also seen cases whereby someone conceives after a period of 8 months. However, if it goes beyond 1 year, then you need to seek medical attention, because with an implant, you shouldn't go beyond a year without conceiving. So what am I trying to say? If you insert an implant and remove it at any time of your choice, you should conceive within a period of 6 months. Once it reaches a year, you need to seek for medical answers. Something needs to be done, need to do some investigations to find out why you are not conceiving. So, with family planning and regaining fertility, it depends on the method. If it's a barrier method like an IUD, a condom, a diaphragm, spermicides, you regain fertility immediately. These other hormonal methods, pills, implants, and so on, fertility is gained between 1 month and a year. Above 1 year, go and make interventions as find out why you are not conceiving, get treatment. Now, we have another question here. It's from Stefan Duz Biam. She says, can a pregnant woman still ovulate in her early stages of pregnancy? This is absolutely not possible. Once you get pregnant, once you conceive, you can no longer ovulate. Because we discussed about ovulation and getting pregnant and so on, there is hormonal interplay. Ovulation is brought about by a hormone called luteinizing hormone. The moment conception takes place, progesterone shoots up. The levels of progesterone go high. And when the levels of progesterone go high, luteinizing hormone will go down. Actually, during ovulation, there is a surge in the luteinizing hormone. Luteinizing hormone reaches its peak. Once it reaches its peak, it will sharply decline. Therefore, you cannot ovulate when you are pregnant. If it's your very first time to watch this channel, please don't forget to subscribe and also press the notification bell in order to be notified of any important video we upload. And if you'd like to ask any question, go to all our social media platforms, ask a question on the timelines. I'll pick some questions and answer them. And if you want your question to be private, you don't want anyone to know about what you're asking, then you will have to book an appointment via my website, and we have a one-on-one chat. That is www.druthuman.com. Book an appointment, we shall discuss together. I sign out. Ask Dr. Uthuman on Sawa Wall.